What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and today Apple released iOS 15 Beta 3 to registered developers 3 weeks after the release of the second developer beta. And for public beta testers, you should be seeing Beta 3 soon, and I will keep you posted on Twitter when that does get released. Now, in addition to iOS, we also got iPadOS 15 Beta 3, watchOS 8 Beta 3, tvOS 15 Beta 3, macOS Monterey Beta 3, and HomePod OS 15 Beta 3. But of course, in this video, we're talking all about iOS and iPadOS 15 Beta 3. So let's start off with the size of this update. And you can see here, it came in about 1.3 gigabytes on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. That size will of course vary depending on the device you're on and the version you're coming from, but that is coming from Beta 2. Now let's go and check out the build number if we go to our settings. And let's go to general about 15.0. And you can see the build here is 19A5297E. So we do have an E at the end of the build number, which indicates, of course, that we do have several betas to go. Now, if we go down to the modem firmware, you can see that has also been updated in this release to 2.07.01. So if you were having cell connectivity issues like I was, those could be resolved thanks to this modem update. So now what's new here in iOS 15 Beta 3? And of course, as expected, we do have quite a few changes. I've discovered at least 20 new features and changes found in this update. And the first one I want to talk about is, as you can see right here, the music widget. This is the first thing I noticed. When I started playing music, I noticed that the music widget has changed for the first time ever since it was introduced in iOS 14.0. So you can see now, when you play a song or have a song paused, it actually changes the entire look of the widget. So now it color coordinates, it's dynamic based on the cover art for the album or song. And you can see here when I go ahead and play this song, let's go ahead and play this, and now you can see it says now playing. So it says now playing and pause. You tap on it, you can pause it. Now you can't play and pause from the widget itself, but you can see there it updates instantly as well. So that's new. Before, it would take a while to update. And also you can tell that the album artwork is a little bit smaller now on this widget. And if I go ahead and play another album, so you can see like a different color, let's just go to this orange right here. So if we play this right here, you can see the color of that widget changes dynamically. So that is really cool. And then also I noticed that when you close out of the music application, you can see that it goes back to normal. So this only changes when you are actually playing a song or when you just paused a song, but still, really, really cool change here in Beta 3. Now we also have quite a few changes inside of the Safari application. I'm gonna bring over Beta 2 here on the left. So we're gonna have Beta 2 on the left, Beta 3 on the right throughout this video. And if we go into Safari, we have quite a few changes. Now, one of the first things you'll notice is that when you type in the address bar, we need to go and tap on the address bar right there, you can see that it now stays at the bottom instead of going up top. So this design makes a lot more sense, and you can see what you're typing easier right here. So like if we wanted to go to a different website, you can see, and we also have some different little functions up top. So we have this little sparkly thing right there, which I guess is just using a suggestion. That was not there before, but if we go ahead to apple.com, you can see it now shows it down here at the bottom instead of up top, which I like a lot better. And you could also see that the bookmarks bar is no longer there. That used to be there on Beta 2, but now it doesn't show anything up there in the top right. So just an all new look when you're typing in to the address bar. And speaking of that address bar, if you tap and hold to haptic press onto the address bar, you can see that we now get a new reload button. So if you wanted to refresh, I'm not sure if this is really any quicker than just swiping up on the page, but you do now have a reload button there from haptic pressing on the address bar. And then Apple also got rid of the move to tab group via haptic press right here. Now we also have a couple of changes in iPadOS 15 Beta 3 related to Safari. So first off, you can see that we have this dedicated share button now up in the top right hand corner. And then also we have a reload button or a refresh button there inside of the address bar to the right of it. So that shows up in landscape. And then if we go into portrait, you can see that it also shows up in portrait mode right there. Same with the share button, also available in portrait mode. And then also if we tap on the sidebar right here, you can see that we have a new section for shared with you in Beta 3. Now we also have some changes to the all new focus mode. So if we go to our settings and then go to focus right here, you will notice a few changes. So first off, we no longer have focus status or phone calls on the main screen right here. Those are actually inside, nested inside of these settings now. And then if we go into one of our focus modes. So for example, if I go into recording a video, you will notice a few changes. So first off, we have this section right here that says options, and you can see we have little glyph icons next to them, whereas we did not have glyph icons before. They've also turned blue now instead of just, you know, having dull colors. Also down here, turn on automatically, you can see is now switched. So smart activation is up top instead of down below. And then also this has that little blue accent right there as well. Then add schedule or automation is new right there. And it showed up a little bit differently on beta 2. And for share focus status before, there was simply just an option for that to turn it on or off. But now in beta 3, we have our own section for focus status right there. So if you tap on that, it shows you a little image of what you can expect or what the setting actually does. Instead of just saying it, we now have a visual and you can turn that on or off, and it shows exactly how it's worked. And this of course is if you want other people to be able to see when you are in a focus mode. So it says that you have notifications silenced. So that's cool that we have our own section now for the focus status. Also, when we go into things like the home screen and lock screen, you can see that we have the option to hide notification badges. Also, I noticed that this little bug that was there in betas 1 and beta 2, where this would just remain gray after you click on it, is no longer there in beta 3. So it seems a lot less buggy and just looks a lot more lively, especially with these glyph icons and the little blue color throughout. It looks a lot better than it did in betas 1 and 2. And then if we go into the allowed notifications section right here where it says people and apps, if we go to people, for example, you can see that it shows allowed people on top now, and we have that same green color, and it just looks a lot more clean than it did in beta 2. We also have the allow calls from, and you can choose that right there. Whereas in beta 2, that was back here on the main page under phone calls, and it would show it right there. You can see that section is also completely reworked here in beta 3. So just a ton of changes to the focus mode options here in beta 3. I like it a lot better. And then two final things about the focus modes before we move on to the next change. You can see here when we haptic press on that focus mode on the lock screen, you can see a slight change there. And then also when we tap on new focus, we actually get a new pre-made focus mode right here. So if we go ahead, need to unlock for that for whatever reason, we have mindfulness now. So before it just showed driving, fitness, and reading, but now mindfulness is a new pre-made little focus mode there. Also new in beta 3, if you go to our settings and go to general, and then down where it used to be reset, it is now transfer or reset iPhone down there at the bottom. And if we tap on that, you can see that we have a whole new section here, a whole new look to this menu. So before, it would just show the settings, of course, that we're used to, erase all content and settings, reset all settings, things like that. The only new one was prepare for new iPhone in betas 1 and 2. But now in beta 3, we have this whole new look on this section right here. And when you tap on reset, you get these options right here to do all of this. It just takes up less room, and it also gives you a visual right here. I like this a lot better. And speaking of settings, we also have some new settings inside of Maps. So if we go into our map settings right here and then go down, you can see it used to say navigation and guidance, but now it just says spoken directions. And when you tap on that, you could see we have a new option here for directions on radio. And then we have pause podcast and directions wake iPhone. So all of those are new here. You can see they just had different verbiage and just a whole new section here in beta 3. It's a little bit more condensed. And also the share ETA is not there. It's probably just because I haven't set it up for this phone, but you can see the different options right there. Or actually, I just noticed that the share ETA is now moved outside of spoken directions, now in the main section of maps instead of being tucked away inside of navigation and guidance. So that is also a change here in beta 3. Now we also have a couple of changes inside of the weather application. So when we tap on these three lines down here, before you could see that it would just kind of go to it and have no animation. And when we go into it, it'd be kind of buggy and just very slow with no real animation. That was beta 2. But now in beta 3, you can see it's much smoother and we have an animation when we go in and out of this list view for the weather. And then also if we go into the temperature map right here and we change this to precipitation, so let's go ahead and change this over to precipitation, you will notice that it now says instead of hourly forecast, it shows us a multi-day forecast. And when we press play on that, you will notice that this little bar down here, this little section goes away or it gets smaller, whereas in beta 2, it would just stay there like this. So if we tap on the map like so, you can see that it goes away, whereas in beta 2, it never went away. And when we tap again, it pulls it up. So that is new here in beta 3. We also have brand new shortcut actions for background sounds. So background sounds is of course a new feature in iOS 15. And you can see now inside of the shortcuts application, we can set background sounds, set background soundtrack, set background sounds volume, things like that. Whereas before we did not have anything that we could do with background sounds. We also got a couple of new splash screens here in beta 3. So first off, you can see inside of the App Store, when you first open up App Store, you get this new splash screen that says in-app events, App Store widget, and Safari extensions on iOS. So this splash screen is just telling us about what's new here in the App Store in iOS 15. We also got a new one when opening up Reminders that talks about organizing with tags, optimizing with Smart List, and lots more. And then also we got this right here when you open up Health for the first time. It asks you once again if you want to share your data with Apple. I did it before, but for whatever reason, it popped up again. Some people are also seeing a new splash screen for Health, but I did not get one here in beta 3. I just got this right here where it asks to share my data with Apple. Now, as for bug fixes, at the time of recording this, Apple has not released the release notes for beta 3 yet. So we don't know the specifics of everything that has been fixed. I will cover that in my follow-up video coming on Saturday. So if you want to see all of the things that have been fixed, stay tuned for that video. But there are a couple of things that I've noticed just after playing with it for a little while that have been resolved. And the first thing is inside of our iCloud. So if we go here and then go to iCloud and then to Private Relay, you will notice that that was completely smooth. In betas 1 and 2, it would just simply hang when you went to iCloud in general, but especially with Private Relay and Hide My Email. It'd be extremely slow and just hang there for sometimes up to like 20 seconds before it went in. So Hide My Email is still a little bit slow just because it does have to load up all your emails, but Private Relay and just the iCloud settings overall are a lot faster here in beta 3 than they were before. And I've also noticed that Private Relay in general is better here in beta 3 because it has not randomly disconnected yet. Whereas before, every time I turned it on, it would just randomly disconnect almost right away, and it has not done that here in beta 3. So I would expect Private Relay got even more, you know, fixes and updates here in beta 3. I would also expect this update to fix the Wi-Fi bug. So iOS 14.7 RC did fix the Wi-Fi bug where if you put a percent sign in your, you know, SSID for that Wi-Fi and connect to it, it would break your Wi-Fi. I would assume that has been fixed here in beta 3 since Apple did fix that with iOS 14.7. And then Safari overall just feels a lot smoother here in beta 3. I mean, we do have the change with the address bar being down here, which is really nice, but just overall, everything feels smoother. And then also every time I closed out of multiple tabs at once, I did not get a crash. So for once, you know, my Safari was not crashing when I would close out of like 5 tabs rapidly. So that is also good news. So I would expect a ton of fixes to Safari to be listed in the release notes when Apple does push those out. And then also one other bug fix that I mentioned in beta 2 that has been fixed here in beta 3. When you pull up this right here and go to background image, you can see this is no longer cut off. Whereas before, it would only show like 2 of these images and the rest would be cut off. That has been fixed here in beta 3. And now background images in Safari on the start page show up properly. Now, as far as other bugs go that I've been experiencing over the past few weeks, and these may be fixed, and I will let you guys know in my follow-up video on Saturday if they have been fixed, but the number one issue I've been having is, I've really had 2 big issues, but one of them is going to be with notification sounds. So sometimes when I get a notification from Snapchat or ESPN or any app that has its own unique sound, when you get a notification, it will just come across in the default sound. So you will get default notification sounds when it should be the unique, you know, sound dedicated to that specific application. I don't know if that's been fixed yet. I will let you guys know. I've also had issues with Apple Music and Bluetooth. So sometimes my Bluetooth will just randomly disconnect when I'm listening to music, mainly when I'm using the music application. I've not had it when I'm using like YouTube and playing that over Bluetooth. It seems to be an issue with Bluetooth and Apple Music. So hopefully that gets resolved as well. And I will let you guys know by Saturday. Now, as far as performance goes, I'm really hoping and praying that beta 3 is better than beta 2, because as you guys know, I made it very clear on Twitter that my experience with beta 2 has just simply not been great. And I also mentioned this in my last 2 follow-up videos over the past 2 weekends, that beta 2 has just really not been up to par for what I expected from a second beta. Now, of course, this is a beta. I'm not complaining. Of course, I am expecting bugs. I'm expecting crashes. I'm expecting all of that. I'm not complaining at all. I'm just simply saying that the performance started out strong. In the first week, it was actually good. I actually said good things about it. But over the past 2 weeks, it's just been brutal. I've actually had to reboot my device multiple times because it would just be lagging. You know, I'd be going in and out of applications with lag. When I would try to type, the keyboard would lag. things like that. And the reboot does fix it, but it just gets very frustrating. So I am hoping that beta 3 does fix that. And I will let you guys know in my follow-up video, I will run a quick Geekbench test just to show you guys the scores here and see how they compare to beta 2. All right, so as you can see, we got a 1593 on the single core and a 4127 on the multi-core compared to beta 2. You can see the scores are very, very close. Really not a big difference at all in the Geekbench scores. And those don't really tell the full story, but I know some people do like seeing what I score in that test. Now, as far as battery life goes here in beta 3, I would expect this to be better as well, because beta 2 was just simply not good on my daily driver. My iPhone 12 Pro really did not get great battery life at all throughout the beta 2 stages. And I almost feel like the re-release was just worse in terms of the performance and the battery life. So I'm not sure what's going on there, but I would expect battery life to be better here on beta 3. So now what is next for Apple? And let's first talk about public beta testers. So if you are on the public beta, you should be seeing public beta 3, which is the same build as developer beta 3, as early as tomorrow, July 15th, or as late as sometime early next week. I would think that you would get it sooner than later, but who knows with Apple. And then as for iOS 15 beta 4, I would expect to see that within 2 weeks. So Apple does usually stick to a 2-week cycle until some of the later betas. So I would expect Apple to be on a 2-week cycle. And if we were gonna go exactly 2 weeks, which Apple has shown they don't always do, it's really just when they're ready. But if that were the case, that would be July 28th. But I would say that it could come really any day on the week of the 26th. That's just my preliminary guess. Of course, a lot of factors go into it, and I will let you guys know if anything changes over on Twitter or in my follow-up videos, which I release every single weekend on Saturday. But yeah, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 15 beta 3. Quite a few changes, and I'm sure there are even more features and changes that I did not discover yet, and I will talk about in my follow-up video. But if you guys enjoyed this video, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up, and of course, make sure to subscribe for a lot more iOS 15 coverage. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.